Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, I welcome you all to this video. This video is very important as we start with the another popular device of microwave linear beam tube family, that is multicavity klystron. Up till now, the another popular that we have seen, that is two cavity klystron, as the name suggests, there were the two cavities, one buncher and another catcher cavity. So here in this device, there are more than two cavities. So let us see the details with respect to the previous video, extended interaction, which was meant for the purpose of improvement into the efficiency and the overall gain of the device. So we start with our topic, multi-cavity klystron amplifiers. So in two cavity klystron amplifier, approximately the overall gain into the decibels, it was 30 decibels and the efficiency was also less. So for improvement, the extended interaction, the idea is to be implemented, that is having cascading of more than two re-entrant cavities in such a fashion that the output of the first re-entrant cavity is provided as input to the second, and this way we can have improvement into the efficiency and that of the overall gain. So commercially, up to seven cavities cascaded to one another are possible and available into the market. So now we shall be taking the example of four cavity klystron working as amplifier. So let us draw the diagram. So as the microwave tube onto the left hand side is having collector at the right hand side and the cathode onto the left hand side, we'll draw the two terminals here. So here we have the cathode and here we have the collector here. So this will be the casing for cathode and collector, and in between there will be the microwave tube and the resonant cavities here. DC input to microwave tube to operate here. So the DC input here will be the negative terminal for the cathode element. So it will be also called as the heating element, and the positive terminal going to the collector. So here I mention the collector that is having the electron bunches collected finally that are deficient into the energy, as the energy is given totally to the potential of the catcher cavity. So here this cavity, the fourth one, will be acting as catcher cavity, or it can also be called to be the output cavity. The first cavity will be responsible for velocity modulation to occur and will be called as buncher cavity or input cavity. So here to the buncher cavity, we provide input of signal to be amplified, hence we write here RF in here. So this is the cathode, or these two rods can also be written to be as electron beam focusing rods, or sometimes this portion is also said to be the electron gun here. Now the heating element is shown here. Now these are the gap spacings between the grids of the re-entrant cavities. Here in this diagram I have drawn the toroidal type of re-entrant cavities. Now while having the cascading of these re-entrant cavities, what should be the gap spacing or the spacing between the cavities from one another? So as into the previous device, two cavity klystron amplifier, while having the derivations and further analysis, we have encountered X as the bunching parameter, and for the maximum efficiency, having the mode N is equal to 2 or 1 3/4, we have specified the value of bunching parameter X is equal to 1.841. So it is necessary to arrange the cavities separated by the distance of 1.841 so that the maximum efficiency and maximum overall gain will be achieved by using the multi-cavity klystron. Here the number of cavities, here we have 4 here. Now the gap spacing between the cavities the grids, it will be marked by small d as usual. And if you take the distance scale for the very next cavities here, we shall be adding the distance of 1.841 to d here. So here it will be d plus 1.841. It will be twice d plus 1.841. So this way we can go up to the catcher cavity right from the gap spacing of the first buncher cavity up to the catcher cavity. There it will be the drift space. So initially in the two cavity klystron working as amplifier, the interaction between the microwave, this is the microwave signal to be amplified here, and from the catcher cavity we can take out the output here. This we can name RF out here. So interaction was taken place at this place and at this place only. Now it has been extended to this gap spacing also, because we have increased the number of re-entrant cavities here. So as we have switched from two cavity klystron to multi-cavity klystron, from the name it is very very clear that the change it, the number of cavities has been increased. There is another change as we switch from that two cavity klystron to the multi-cavity klystron with respect to the analysis and the overall performance of the device. In the two cavity klystron, here it was only one buncher cavity and the only one catcher cavity. The velocity modulation used to produce the accelerated electron and decelerated electron into the drift space, and finally up to the position of gap spacing between catcher cavity grids, there used to be the electron bunch. So when from cathode terminal to collector terminal, number of electrons are passing together, we call it to be the simply electron plasma if the number of electrons is very much in number. Now in multi-cavity klystron, we have extended the interaction also, and it is very very necessary here to deal with the space charge effect into the microwave tube. The space charge effect can be also explained as the interaction between the two electrons that are a part of electron beam. So as both the electrons will be of negatively charged, obviously there will be a force of repulsion between them. So force of repulsion between the electrons, if the dense plasma is available running into the microwave tube, so it will be either into the axial direction. So axial direction will be this direction, or the radial direction. So it will be perpendicular to this one. So there are chances that both directions will be available for the interactions, or simply we call the space charge interaction into the microwave tube. Now here the width of the microwave tube is limited. So ideally if the width of the microwave tube is not considered, the radial direction if we consider to be at the infinity, so that time we can have the parameters discussed for this particular multi-cavity klystron working as amplifier in terms of charge densities. So charge will be basically the electron, and the charge density for the electron can be denoted by here. It will be the rho, and the mathematical representation of rho calculation will be given in terms of capital B cosine of beta suffix e into z cosine of omega qt added with theta here. Whereas whatever the space charge interaction is there, so there it will be the velocity perturbation of the electrons flowing into the electron beam, and that velocity perturbation can be denoted as by this symbol, and it will be given by minus capital C sine of beta e into z into sine of, here we have omega qt added with theta. So in these two equations, I name them equation number one and equation number two, capital B is the constant charge density perturbation. So I mentioned here whereas capital C is given as constant of velocity perturbation. Now there is another constant denoted by beta suffix e. So beta we generally represent for the phase constant here. So here beta suffix e is given by omega divided by this V0, which is a DC phase constant for the electron beam. Now along with omega, here we have another representation with respect to the frequency, that is omega suffix q here. So omega suffix q is given as capital R times omega suffix p here. So omega suffix q is actually the reduced plasma frequency, whereas omega suffix p denotes the plasma frequency. So whatever the electron plasma is running from cathode to that of the collector, so initially if it is having the space charge effect not into the consideration, we consider the omega suffix p here the plasma frequency. Because of the space charge effect, there will be the practical limitation to that particular frequency. Hence, the reduction factor will be denoted by capital R, and the effective plasma frequency we denote by omega suffix q and name it as reduced plasma frequency. Now here, omega suffix p can be given by the formulation omega suffix p is equal to square root of e into rho suffix 0 divided by m into epsilon 0. So this is the plasma frequency. Plasma frequency of electron beam. And finally, theta is the last parameter. Theta is the phase angle of oscillation. So as just now we have seen the relation with the omega suffix q with omega suffix p, it was omega suffix q is equal to capital R times omega suffix p, R being the reduction factor. So this R is basically the function of radius of the electron beam and the ratio small n. So let us say the radius of the electron beam can be denoted by small r, and the ratio small n, it is actually the ratio of the tunnel beam radius with respect to the electron beam radius here. So if we have the value of beta suffix e into r is equal to 0.85, and the value of the ratio denoted by small n is equal to 2. So this implies that omega q will be equal to 1 upon 0.5 times omega suffix p. It means r is equal to 0.5. So this gives us omega q will be equal to 2 times omega p. So the reduction factor is here 2 here. Now here we shall be considering the charge density because of the DC potential applied as well as the RF potential between the gap spacings of the two grids here. Therefore, the total charge density can be denoted by rho suffix for total, I write TOT here, and it will be given by minus rho suffix 0 added with rho here. Whereas the total velocity perturbation can be denoted here by this symbol, and it will be depending on to the velocity perturbation along with another velocity perturbation. Here rho 0 is equal to the DC electron charge density. whereas rho is equal to instantaneous RF charge density. The velocity perturbation can be denoted here because of the DC potential applied. So it will be DC electron velocity simply. And this is the instantaneous electron velocity perturbation. Now, as we call the flow of electrons to be the flow of current here, for the multi-cavity klystron amplifier, the case of four cavities here, we shall be having the formulation with respect to the current density, and the current density is usually represented by capital J. So therefore, we can have the total amount of current density denoted by J suffix TOT, and it will be given by minus J0 added with capital J. So in this equation, we can write J0 will be equal to DC beam current density, and the capital J will be equal to instantaneous RF beam current density. Now the J total can be given further. The multiplication of the charge density and the velocity perturbation. Therefore, we write here rho total into the velocity perturbation total here. So from the previous equations, we can make the substitutions, and the J total can be given as, we put here minus rho 0 added with rho in multiplication to that of V0 with V here. So finally, we can have the four terms to the next step. It will be minus rho 0 into V0 into again minus rho 0 into simply V added with rho into V0 and rho into V. So this will be minus J0 added with G here. So therefore, J0 can be denoted as, it will be rho 0 into V0, and capital J, it will be rho V0 minus rho 0 V. So here we can neglect rho into V, which will be very small. So as we have given the formulation for the total amount of the charge density, we shall be making the use of current continuity equation. According to the current continuity equation, we have here del bar dot of J bar is equal to minus del rho upon. So here J bar represents the conduction current density. So del bar dot of J bar is actually the divergence here. So it is actually the partial differential of this J bar with respect to the space. Whereas here we have the partial time derivation of the rho, where rho is the charge density. Now J bar we have expressed as rho into V0 minus rho 0 into V. Therefore, we can write the left hand side, that is del bar dot of J bar, is equal to del del Z of, whereas the direction of propagation of electron beam we consider into the Z direction only, hence we take from the rectangular coordinates del del Z here. So it will be given by minus omega into capital B into sine of beta E into Z minus omega T into cosine of omega q times t added with theta here. So this will be the first term, and it will be added further to the second term given as beta suffix e into rho 0 into capital C, the constant for velocity perturbation, into the cosine of beta suffix e times z minus omega t into the sine of omega q t added with theta here. And the right hand side for the current continuity equation can be given by, so it will be minus del del t of rho is equal to minus omega into capital B sine of, here we have the phase constant in multiplication to the distance parameter z, minus omega t into cosine of omega q t added with theta. And this is added with the second term here. So this was the first term of the RHS. It will be omega suffix q into capital B cosine of beta e into z minus omega t into the sine of omega q t added with theta here. So therefore, finally, we can express omega q into b is equal to the phase constant beta suffix e for the electron beam into the charge density rho 0 into the constant capital C here. So I outline this relation. This relation is very, very essential. So now the conduction current density for the device and the velocity perturbations can be expressed by the next two equations. So the current density equation we give as capital J will be equal to velocity perturbation due to the DC potential into capital B in multiplication to the cosine of beta E into Z minus omega T cosine of omega Q T added with theta. So this is added with omega Q divided by omega V0 into capital B, the constant, in multiplication to, here we have sine of beta EZ minus omega T into sine of omega QT plus theta here. Next, for the velocity perturbation, we can write, it will be denoted as minus V0 into beta I into V1 divided by twice V0 in capitals into cosine of beta suffix Q into Z in multiplication to the sine of beta suffix E into Z minus omega T here. So as we have these two equations, for the current density equation, in the second term of the RHS, we have the ratio omega suffix q divided by omega. So for practical devices, this ratio will be giving us very, very small value. Hence, the second term onto the right hand side can also be neglected. Hence, thereafter, we can consider J is equal to the velocity perturbation due to the DC voltage into the B constant into cosine of beta suffix EZ minus omega T into the cosine of omega suffix QT added with theta here. Now, as the electron passes through the gap of the two grids for the reentrant cavity, firstly occurring as buncher cavity, the modulated velocity of the electron can be given by the equation. And let us assume that the time moment will be T1. So for time moment T1, the velocity will be denoted by V as a function of T1 equal to V0 in multiplication to the square bracket having 1 plus, here we have beta suffix I V1 divided by twice capital V0 into sine of omega tau here. So in this equation, beta suffix I is the beam coupling coefficient of the input cavity here. V1 is the maximum magnitude of the RF signal to be amplified. Capital V0 is the DC potential applied, and tau is the transit time of the electron in the electron beam here. Now, the tau, that is transit time, will be actually the ratio of D divided by V0. So it is distance covered upon the velocity. So due to the DC potential, V0 is the velocity that we have shown here. D is the distance of gap spacing. And finally, if we consider the time moment T1 to be the moment at which the electron leaves it, and the time moment T0, the moment at which the electron enters the gap spacing. So we can mention it as T1 minus T0, the transit time. As the electrons, due to the space charge effect into the electron beam, represents the harmonic motion. So therefore, the velocity of the electron beam, the modulated one, can be given by the equation. The equation will be, so we represent the velocity of perturbation total and given as V0 in multiplication to 1 plus beta I V1 divided by twice capital V0 sine of, here we have omega tau, cosine of omega p t minus omega p times tau here. So omega p is the total plasma frequency. Now the current density capital J can be given by the equation minus 1 by 2 J0 into omega divided by V0 into omega q beta I into V1 into sine of beta q into z into the cosine of here beta suffix ez minus omega t can be represented. So now here in this equation we have beta suffix q, which will be actually the ratio of omega q with respect to the velocity perturbation of the electron plasma here. So I outline this equation and this equation also. So these equations will be very much helpful to us in solving the problems based on the concepts of multicavity klystron as amplifier. So by the next lecture we shall be having problem one, multicavity klystron. So I suppose you are definitely getting the knowledge for microwave engineering. For more information like this, you can subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you.